it's Flexible Friday. My name is Janelle, and not only am I a professional dancer, but I'm also a holistic healthcare practitioner. And I'm here today in Santa Ana, California at one of the studios that I teach at. This is Mbrz Dance Studios. So I want to talk today a little bit about this stretchy guy here, this thing that maybe you got from your physical therapist a couple of years ago and you just kind of tossed it in the back of your car and you don't know what to do with it anymore. The stretchy band that sometimes you see people at the gym and maybe they're doing these like bicep curl things, you know. We're gonna talk about what you can really do with this item that's called your TheraBand. Let's go. Let's start with our TheraBand in our hands. I like to place it in between my thumbs and then I spread my arms open wide, a bit wider than shoulder distance. My legs are also wide. And then I send my arm bones out and I stretch my arms again. I'm feeling the resistance of the TheraBand and I pull up my waist, inhale and puff my chest. And then I start to send my arm bones back. I send the arm bones back until I meet resistance. And suppose you're meeting resistance at this point, then bend your knees and start to shift gently from side to side. And the more that your palms are open, the more stretching even of the nerves from the fingertips all the way into the axilla, the armpit area, into the pectoral region that you're gonna feel, and gently shift from side to side and gradually work your arms all the way down and around to the back. Now, if this feels really super challenging, don't be afraid. Go as wide as you need to go with the TheraBand while you're warming up. If it needs to be very wide to start out with, that's totally fine, very wide. So for those of us that are a little bit more flexible, you can go narrow, a little bit more narrow. So again, here we go. Find the point of resistance and shifting from side to side and perhaps involving the neck even. Involve the neck. I'm bending the knees and I'm reaching the arms to the side using the stretch of the TheraBand. That's what's nice about it, that it's stretchy. And then you bring the arms all the way back down. And again, if you can narrow it up, if you feel like you're ready, narrow it up a little bit more. So from here, rotate the heads of the shoulders open, pop the chest, send the arm bones back. Find that point of resistance. Pull the arm bones apart. Stretch the pectoral region wide. Inhale. Puff the chest, and as you inhale, you feel it more into the intercostal muscles, the chest, the things that hold the ribs together, and then bring the arms all the way back over. You feel so lifted and so open. And again, to finish, maybe a couple of head rolls in one direction, a couple of head rolls in the other direction, maybe some shoulder rolls with your elbow rolls, and then notice how big and full range of motion that you have now in your arms, full range of motion, full range of motion with the elbows, full range of motion, and same thing with the shoulders. You'll see a huge difference. No matter how far apart you are or how close together you are, it's all about the opening and expansiveness of the chest. So the second exercise I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull the TheraBand wide, and I'm gonna move one arm at a time. So I'm gonna send one arm diagonally across my body, trying to lengthen the arm out, so I'm not gonna allow the elbow to come into this bent shape here, but I'm gonna continue to lengthen the arm. Same thing with my opposite arm. They're lengthening. I stretch the band wide and bring my arm up and over my head behind. Now my second arm comes up and over from behind. Now I'm back to the front, and then I'm gonna reverse it. So now that second arm that I move becomes the first arm, comes forward and across the body, stretch the band wide by this. Second arm stays down, up and over, lengthen the arm, don't let it bend, lengthen the arm up and over behind. Second arm comes from behind, up and over. Now you're all the way back in the front. And again, don't be afraid to take it wide. If this area is a tight area for you, it's okay. Take it wide and work with it wide to start out. Up and over, and reverse. Diagonal, the arms stay straight and lengthened and long. Up and forward and down and across, diagonal, up and over, across, diagonal. Even that in itself, if the band is this wide, it's okay. But if you do want a bit more of a challenge, just narrow it up and then lengthen the band, and then you've got the resistance and the stretch, and then you're feeling more depth in the sides here of the body and really opening up those arms. So we're gonna start out by interlacing the hands together. And then from here, I wanna roll the heads of the shoulders back and pull the arm bones down. I mean, this may even just be enough for you, just to stand and be able to go inhale and puff the chest and interlacing these hands. And again, this clasping here together, lift and puff. I mean, if you're at work and you need a break for a second, inhale, exhale, and then look up. Oh, it feels excellent on the body, even if you can just maintain this position for a second. Now, if you want to go a little bit further, step the legs really wide, super wide, turn the toes in. Pull the arm bones down, maintaining that clasp. You can probably see my hands in between my legs here. Look all the way up to the ceiling. This is the full position. I maintain the lift of the chest, and like an axe over my head, I send my arms up and over and reach my head through, and the arm bones come down to the ground, maintaining this nice clasp here. And then I stay there and I feel that deep opening in the heads of my shoulders. Now, for those of you that need some hamstring help, this is also great for your hamstring. Just put the block down in front of you. Take the legs wide. Again, the tendency is gonna be that the toes are gonna wanna turn out. Don't do that. Turn the toes inward. It's gonna help you to make happy butt. If the toes turn out, it's harder to make happy butt. If the toes turn in, it's easier to make your happy butt happen, as opposed to sad butt. We need to make happy butt. Turn the toes in order to make happy butt. Pump the chest, clasp the hands, inhale, exhale, throw the arms over, and then the block, because of the tightness in the hamstrings, just keep making happy butt. Make happy butt in this position and then send the arm bones over. And as you can, you lower the block down and down. We lower the block more and more and more until you don't need the block at all. And send the head through and the arms over. And then to come out of it, release the hands, place the hands on the waist. Inhale, pop the chest to come up, and hopefully you feel great. Okay, so that's it for today, everybody. So now you've learned how to use your backseat stretchy doodah here. This is your TheraBand, remember? So pull it out of your backseat of your car and start using it, and for the utilization of your block that I know you got. And thanks so much to Mbrz Dance Studios for letting me film here. If you're ever in the Orange County area and you're interested in taking a pole class, or you want to come and take one of my flexibility classes here at this studio, check out their class schedule at mbrz-ds.com. That's mbrz-ds.com. Check out their class schedule, and we'll see you next week. Thanks, everybody.